15 years as a private eye, and I've never let a crime go unsolved. Hell, maybe if I'd just learned to let a crime go, I'd still be alive today.
Why can't I hear a ring?
You can't be here, mister. Who the hell do you think you are?
The name's Yokes. Private detective, specializing in ovular homicides and disappearances. Now let me do my goddamn job. The pigs had immediately got to interviewing the witness, the victim's dame. But she was in hysterics, and I knew it was no use.
Oh God, it was awful! It was alive. A creature. Monster!
Damn it! Pull yourself together!
Sorry, bad choice of words.
Useless. Besides, I had another clue. I followed her because she was my only lead, but soon enough she had me under her spell. She had eyes like stars in the night, lips smooth like butter, and that perfect aluminium body.
I'll show you what happened to that poor man in the alleyway.
She gave me a night I could never forget.
Your love is my love. There's no love for nobody else.
But when I woke up in the morning, she'd vanished. I'd been a fool to trust her, blinded by her beauty. Left in her place were only four words and a symbol scribbled on a note. A hand, but with five fingers. Strange. And the words, 11 p.m., the milk carton. I knew the place. It was a local bar in the area. A breeding ground for scumbags and schmucks. I didn't trust it for a second, but it was the only lead I had. I arrived at the bar at the time she said, but it was empty. Should have been full at this time. There was something in the air. Something fishy.
We don't serve breakfast here, Yokes.
How do you know my name?
I know everything about you, Yokes.
How about you pour us two drinks and we have a chat?
Sorry, Yokes, all out of drinks. How about instead we make ourselves a nice omelette?
It had been a trap all along and I'd fallen for it. I was lucky to survive, but it wasn't my first time in a situation like this. Before I could get an upper hand, he'd made a run for it. It was time to scramble. He was fast for sure, but I was faster. Stop right there! He was my only lead on this murder, and I wasn't about to let him slip away. 90 cases I've sold over my career, 90. Yet now I barely even knew where to start. Who were these people? And what did they have to do with the murders? And that symbol, what could it mean?
What can I hear rain?
Rain? The sound of rain on the night of the murder, but no one held an umbrella. Was it raining or dry? And there was some other clue, something I'd missed. Where the hell was his yoke? Some cult, some great beast. I knew this was the end, that there was no hope for escape. My best option was to accept my fate and take it with dignity. Maybe I could have seen this coming if I hadn't been so blinded by lust. But what did it matter now?
I don't know what to say, but how are you doing on this fine and lovely day? I don't know. Is that good enough, I guess?